Hey, Mariah, I'm kind of nervous, a little bit. It's good nervous, though. Love you. Can't wait to get the day going, I guess. Can't wait to see you walk down the aisle. Love you.
Hey, Spins. This has been a long time coming. I've loved you since the sixth grade. I'm about to start crying, but I can't wait to be your wife. I love you.
Hi, Mariah. Hi, Spencer. No more stress. Today, it's good. Good luck.
Congratulations, Spencer and Mariah. Mariah, happy to have you as part of the family. Hope you have a special day.
And I'm so happy to have her in our family.
It's a great day for you guys, and we love you both and wish you the best. And congratulations, Grandpa and Grandma Feaster.
No, not yet.
I love you too. You're one of my favorites.
I've known you since we've been 2 years old, and I can't believe you're already getting married, but I wish you guys the best and good luck and congratulations.
Oh, it's me.
And me.
And Ren.
And we love you guys, and we're so happy for you. And we hope we dance out Ren tonight.
See ya!
Spencer, you made a huge mistake.
Yeah, never really liked you.
Hey, come on now.
Just kidding.
Until next time. Yeah, best of luck. Hey, let us know how it is. So I don't make the same. I'm kidding. Hey, everybody have a good day. Have a good honeymoon.
Okay, so I've known Spencer since we were playing G.I. Joe's in the house with Claire, which is baby. And then I got the privilege to surprise tennis partner and got two best friends. I just cannot believe that my two best friends from childhood and high school are getting married. And I'm so excited. And good luck.
Okay, Mariah and Spencer, we wish you all the luck. You'll have to go.
Just do everything Mariah tells you to do, and you will have a wonderful, wonderful life. Love you guys. Wish you the best. Happy ever after.
And yeah, Spencer, just get used to it.
Just wanted to let you know, love you very much. I know you guys are excited to start the rest of your life together. Can't wait to see where God takes you in your journey, and super excited for you guys. Love you both.
just a game for two. Two in life can't make it. Take my heart, but please don't break it in love. It's making me angry.
Blessings, Lord, you just bless us beyond measure, and we are thankful. Thank you for Mariah and Spencer, and just their courtship and their time together, and it's awesome to see them together forever now. And Lord, bless them financially, and bless them as Mariah is going through school, and just be near them, draw close to them. And Lord, I pray now that you bless the food as we get ready to eat, and bless those as we leave later, and keep them safe. And just let us have a great celebration and a great time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I'm going to first start by introducing myself. My name is Crimson, and I am Mariah's older sister. I'm not going to lie, when I realized that it was my turn to give the speech, I am glad I reached out a little bit. Because, well, we all know I'm not very good at talking in front of people. So I may or may not have Googled a lot of speakers. And I mean lots. But after reading them, I was convinced nobody would believe me that they were mine and written by me. So I'm still kind of puzzled where I'm going to start. I told myself that all I had to do was maybe talk for 5 minutes, and that wouldn't be rushing it, but yet it wouldn't be boring all of you. But then I got to brainstorming, and well, there's no way 5 minutes is long enough to tell you all the memories that I have with Mariah. I mean, shoot, an entire day would be long enough to tell you all the stories that I have between the two of us. So bear with me, because I'd still like to share a couple of stories between the two of us. Growing up, me and Mariah did so many things together. I mean, shoot, we even shared a room. There was even one time that I remember the best, that Mariah was about probably 6 years old, and she got locked out of the house, and instead of just knocking on the door, she asked our dog, Cheeto at the time, if she could walk down to Grandma's suits. Apparently the dog said yes, because that's exactly what she did. After that night, I remember staying up every night and making sure that she fell asleep before I did, because I was scared she was going to run away. We used to climb bins and skate together out in the shed. We'd ride bikes, go-karting, slide down the treadmill and get in trouble. And I mean, speaking of trouble, one of my favorites is when we used to put on pantyhose and slide around the whole washroom. Which led to us putting holes in the pantyhose, which are oh so many mom in total. We didn't have a home. Which honestly we thought was funny. Mom would spank us, which one of us would laugh, and then the other one would get spanked. Which continued a couple times until we learned that you said big breath. And then there was a time that we were both on motorized scooters. And I was going down the hill and she was going up. We seemed to both be in the middle and one of us needed to move, which wasn't going to happen. So, wouldn't you know it, at the last second, we both moved the same way and crashed. Well, these fun stories all stopped once we hit middle school. We both seemed to go our own ways, but I remember people always saying, someday you two will be great friends. And I thought, yeah, right. She is annoying. I can't stand her. Well, that all changed late high school. We started getting closer and closer. And there's this one story that I really didn't want to tell everybody, but I figured she'd be amused by it, so I'm going to tell it. One day, me, Matt, and Mariah were simply cleaning the house. And Mariah came in with dirty feet. And I told her to go clean her feet. And she refused. So there was a little bit of name calling. And maybe a little bit of throat punching. And she walked out. I was then bothered a little bit by how mad she was at me and had to figure out how I was going to read on myself from getting mad at dirty feet. So, 4 hours later, we were back to being best friends. So I've come to realize that maybe people aren't so crazy when they say that you're going to be best friends, because I now consider Mariah one of my best friends. When I want someone to hang out with, and I mean every day. She's one of the first people I text. She is honestly one of my best friends I've ever had. She is not only funny and beautiful inside and out, but we just get each other. I swear she's going to have the same life mindset. But by this time in high school, Spencer had been hanging around for a while, and he went to every basketball game, every football game, in their senior year. And then after high school, Mariah and I became even closer. I knew Spencer was going to be the one for Mariah. He even told me at my wedding that he was going to propose to her, which I'm kind of thinking what took so long. Of course, I was over the top excited, and today's the day, so I'd like to just congratulate them and toast to them and happily ever after.
I have my phone in front of me and I'm not going to be have a piece of paper in front of me, but just so that all of you know, I'm Spencer's older brother by 2 years. I'll tell you, the whole time that I knew I was going to be the best man, I thought I'd plan a speech out, but I just didn't feel like I would do this stage just for most of my life. So I kind of told myself that I would just kind of come up here, do it on the fly, see how things have been from there. I'll tell you what, I mean, growing up with Spencer was definitely, I'm going to be honest, it's definitely a challenge. Spencer was always the kid that was, he had a real child syndrome after that. He was always trying to strive for attention. He was always trying to get attention from myself, from mom, dad, or from Claire. But when I was younger, I didn't think about it so much. I thought about it whenever he proposed to Mariah. I knew that this whole day was going to happen, and that he really meant everything that he did whenever he was younger. I don't know how many of you guys have read the five love languages. I had kind of the opportunity to read the entire book, but Spencer's definitely, he probably meets M5 in the love languages. He definitely has the acts of service, the touch, physical touch. He has the words of affirmation. I'll tell you, it's not every subject in that book touches Spencer in a certain way. One of the things that I remember most about being Spencer from my heart is that we just moved out to the house that we live in right now. And mom and dad had a dining room table in the middle of the table, and I remember in the middle of the kitchen. And I remember me and Spencer fighting over some kind of piece of clothing that I had gotten for Christmas or something like that. And Spencer said, "No, it's mine." And I knew it was mine, I said it was. Well, Spencer being kind of a salty and hotheads that we were, and we both kind of got into it. And one thing led to another, I had him down by the throne. He was trying to throw punches at me, and that's just kind of how our lives went throughout life. We definitely were friends, but we had our instances where we got at it with each other. I'll tell you, it's definitely an honor being able to stand here and be the best man for my little brother's wedding. I'll tell you, the best moment of my life my junior year in high school. My little brother was a freshman. We're both on the basketball team. And we're junior at the high school. I'm the older girl. We're all going to be in a competition. I'll start with a friend and do what I need to do. But I tell you, my junior senior year, the best 2 years of basketball I've ever played. Not only do I feel like I'm making a better person than I've been playing for years, but I'm never so bad person. I'm a bad person. And I feel like I did not want to do as well as the older brother. Make him better. Make the team better. Well, that's kind of how I feel our relationship's been throughout our whole lives. Basketball was the first instance. We both played baseball together growing up. We both played basketball growing up. We were always competing against each other. And I feel like even though we were both competing against each other, we were both fighting on the court, fighting on the field. After practice, we both come home and talk about practice, how things went, talk about things we could do to make us better. I feel like that was how our lives have been together. Trying to compete against each other to make ourselves better. Well, not each other, before I respect myself, but my wife and I had a baby on Tuesday night, Tuesday afternoon. Wednesday morning, my brother and my little sister walking down. I could not be more excited to see my brother or my little girl. So, with all these things that I'm talking about tonight, it's just kind of different, five different love languages that Spencer's expressed. He's expressed all five different love languages. He's kind of the total package, and I know Mariah knows that he's the total package. And I know that all the Chamberlain girls, and myself, my sister, and my family know these two are perfect for each other. They've been through more than A lot of people in the ministry throughout my relationship with people for 8 or 9 years. I couldn't be more excited for both of you to start the talk together today with you support everybody at this time. So, if everybody keeps raising the glasses, I want to thank you guys all for coming tonight. I want to thank you for all celebrating together and your whole day together. So, cheers to Spencer and Ryan for being together until that new part.
Take my whole For I can't help falling in love with you. Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can't help falling in love with you. For
Thank you.